Hello once again, my name is Mono Mukundu. I'm doing this video in response to a question sent by Phainos Matura. The question is very loaded and I think it's a very important question, so I decided to answer that question with a video. He wanted to know how guitar melodies are created and structured. So, some might ask, what is a melody? A melody is that element of a song that you whistle. What you are whistling is the melody. So basically on a song there are melodies on the instruments and there are melodies on the vocals. So today I'm just going to concentrate on the melodies on the instruments, in particular the lead guitar, because I'm a lead guitarist. So the reason why I decided to do a video is because this question always comes up when I'm recording artists here at the studio. Some artists, they request a lot of melodies in one song. So I always tell them to refer to artists like Leonard Dembo, Oliver Mtukudzi, the Four Brothers, and tell them to listen to how the lead guitars are structured. Because when you are creating music, you don't just play willy-nilly. You create melodies and structure them properly so that it's a song that has got structure. So today I'm going to explain using a Leonard Dembo song. The reason being that Leonard Dembo, according to me, Leonard Dembo was one of the best guitarists we had in Zimbabwe. He had a very good sense of melody. And one thing I like about Leonard Dembo's music is that his melodies were very simple to follow. You can whistle his melodies and you can remember the melodies. And one principle that Leonard Dembo used that was consistent in many of his songs was that minimalistic approach, which I also use, which Pilani Dube used, the same approach also used by Frank, who used to play for the Four Brothers, and even Chimboti used to use the principle a lot. So the principle goes like this. Speaking for myself, usually I prefer to use three melodies only in a song. The melody that I use on the opening, and the melody that I use when the lead vocalist is singing, and then the melody that I use on kushaura or on the guitar solo. So I'm going to use a Leonard Dembo song called Dudzai. The song is 10 minutes long. You know, Leonard Dembo songs were very long, but even though they were long, you wouldn't get bored because the guitar melodies were very good. The structuring was very good. So let's analyze the song. And I want us to count the melodies. We are going to count them as melody number one, melody number two, melody number three. Talking of this song, Dudzai, there was this melody that he kept playing. It goes like... We are going to call that one, I think it's going to be melody number two. Let's play. That's melody number one, that intro. That's melody number two. Then the vocals come in. It goes back to melody number two. Back to melody number two. Back to melody number two. Still on melody number two. We are still on melody number 2. Still on melody number 2. Now we have melody number 3. Goes on Matura. So the point I'm trying to make is that throughout this song, Leonard Dembo used 3 guitar melodies only, and the melodies are very melodic. They are very easy to remember, and that repetition here, you know, it causes the melody to be easy to remember. And one key element of Leonard Dembo's style was every time he started singing, he would stop playing the guitar and he would leave the drums, the bass and the rhythm guitar playing, and he would just concentrate on singing. The reason being that the lead guitar and the lead vocals, they occupy the same space, they serve the same purpose. So every time he would sing, he would stop playing the lead guitar. But with artists like John Chibadura, they wouldn't stop playing. They just revert to a sub-rhythm, what we call sub-rhythm in Zimbabwean music, or something simpler that's not soloing, so that the lead vocals and the lead guitar, they do not compete. So I was really very much interested in Phainos Matura's question, because I always argue with some artists who will tell you every time you come in with the lead guitar, they want a new melody, sometimes very complicated melodies that the fans will not remember. So when you're structuring music, it's very wise to structure your music very well and make sure that the melodies are not too many, so that there's a lot of repetition. I hope I answered your question well, Phainos, and to everybody else, I hope this is something that's helpful. Thank you.
Monolio Studio, the harmony of quality and professionalism.